For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Mortgage Calculator 6 from your Sample Files folder. In the previous lesson, Lesson 9.5, you added an interest-only loan checkbox to this form, and you connected it to the input cell in cell D29. When the checkbox is checked, D29 reads true, and when it's unchecked, it reads false. But the form isn't working properly yet. We haven't yet associated the new input cell with the result cells, so the monthly repayment and total interest are reading exactly the same whether this is a capital and repayment loan or an interest-only loan. We'll now correct those formulas so that they return the correct values. Let's now look at the formula we're using to calculate the monthly repayment in cell D34. So I'll click on cell D34 and then click the Insert Function button to the left of the formula bar. You can see that we're using a PMT function to calculate the monthly repayment. The PMT function was covered extensively in Lesson 3.3. We need to consider the fourth argument, that's the FV argument. You'll remember from Lesson 3.3 that the FV argument either provides a cash bonus at the end of the loan or documents an amount that will still be outstanding when the loan has completed. If, for example, FV was minus 100 and this was a dollar loan, then the borrower would still owe $100 at the end of the loan. And if this value was a positive number, plus 100, that would mean that the borrower would receive a cash bonus at the end of the loan. Now at the moment, we're modelling a capital and repayment mortgage. And at the end of a capital and repayment mortgage, there's no cash bonus, but also you don't owe the lender any money, so FV would normally be zero. However, in the case of an interest-only loan, the loan is never paid off, and you'll always owe the amount you borrowed, even at the end of the term. So it's clear that the value for the FV parameter will be different depending on whether this is an interest-only loan or a capital and repayment loan. So we need to use an if logic function. You learnt all about the if function in Lesson 3.5, so I'll type if and open a bracket to start my if function. The if function accepts three arguments. The first is a logical argument, true or false. And the second and third arguments define what will happen if the if function's logic argument is true or false. So the first argument will be whether this is an interest-only loan or not. So I'll click on cell D29 and type a comma to move on to the second argument. The second argument is what happens if it's true. In other words, if this really is an interest-only loan. Well, if it's an interest-only loan, we'll owe exactly what we borrowed, the amount financed, at the end of the loan. So I'll click on the amount financed in cell D33 and then multiply by minus 1 to make it a negative number. And the next condition is, what about if D29 is false? In other words, if this isn't an interest-only loan, it's a capital and repayment loan. Well, at the end of a conventional capital and repayment loan, you don't owe anything. So the correct value for this argument is 0, and then I'll close the bracket. I'll now click OK, and the PMT function always insists on returning a currency symbol. And because the locale of this computer is the United Kingdom, it's returning a pound sign. So I'll just click Home on the ribbon, and in the number group, the comma style, so that this form can be used internationally. And I think I'll do the same thing to cell D20 while I'm about it. Now let's test the form. At the moment, this is a capital and repayment loan. And with the values on this form, my monthly repayments are $1,666.08. If this was an interest-only loan, I'd expect my monthly repayments to be a lot less. So I'll click on the checkbox and you can see that that is what's happened. The monthly repayment is now only $1,187.50. So I can now move on to my next result cell, the total interest paid. Now, in the case of an interest-only loan, the total interest repaid is every penny I've paid of that loan, because all I'm paying back is interest. So this will simply be the value in cell D35. But in the case of a capital and repayment loan, since we've paid off the amount we borrowed, the interest paid is the difference between the total amount repaid, that's the value in cell D35, and the amount financed. So we'd have to subtract the amount financed from the total repaid. This is a candidate for another if function. So I'll click in cell D36, press the delete key to remove the current formula, and then I'll click formulas on the ribbon. In the function library, the if function is a logical function. So I'll click logical, and there's the if function. And for the logical test, it will be as last time, is this an interest-only loan? So I'll click on cell D29. Now, if it's true and it is an interest-only loan, then every penny that we repaid is interest because we haven't paid off any capital. So I'll click on the total repaid value in cell D35. And if it's not true that it's an interest-only loan, then it must be a regular capital and repayment loan. And that means that the interest paid is the difference between what we borrowed and what we paid back. So the value if false will be the total repaid minus the total financed. I'll click OK, and let's look at the value being returned. Because this is an interest-only loan, the total repaid and total interest are exactly the same, because everything we've paid back is interest. But if I clear the interest-only loan checkbox, you'll see that the values have now changed, so that I'm only paying $214,824 in interest, being the difference between the $499,824 that I repay and the amount I financed, $285,000. Now that the form's working, it's time to test it to make sure that your form is working correctly. So follow through on your computer and enter the same numbers that I have on mine. Property price of $350,000, a 20% deposit, and a $5,000 arrangement fee. And you should see an amount financed of $285,000. If you don't see this, there's something wrong with one of your formulas. Then for the term, I think instead of 25 years, I'll go for a 20-year term. And for the interest rate, I'll stay with 5%. And for the annual income after tax, I'll stay with $38,000. So you should now see a monthly repayment of $1,880.87. If you see a different number, you'll have to backtrack and try and figure out which of your formulas has gone wrong. And now let's look at all of the result cells. You should be seeing exactly the same numbers in your result cells that I'm seeing in mine. Once again, if not, you'll need to go back and correct those formulas. And now let's change this loan to an interest-only loan. You can see I'm paying $1,880 as a capital and repayment loan, but when I click the interest-only loan checkbox, that reduces to $1,187.50. You should see that number on your machine too. And if you look at the input and result cells, you should also be seeing exactly the same numbers that I'm seeing here. Well, assuming that your form works, all that remains is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name Mortgage Calculator 7. And as usual, I'll save to the folder above my sample files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed Lesson 9.6, Use Checkbox Data in Result Cells.